Former Philippine Senate President Juan Ponce Enrile is in the hospital to be treated for COVID. Enrile revealed in a Facebook post he has been at a Makati hospital for 3 days. He said he never had any discomfort other than dry, intermittent, and sometimes intense coughing. Enrile also admitted a CT scan showed he had mild COVID pneumonia, but the 98-year-old insisted he is not going to die yet. Due to this development, Enrile says he would miss President-elect Marcos's oath taking on Thursday, as he will still be in the hospital by then. Enrile was recently appointed as Marcos's chief presidential legal counsel.
The Philippine Health Department reported 867 new cases Monday, the country's highest daily tally in over 3 months. The number of active cases has reached 7,000 and is the highest since April 30. The Philippines averaged 662 new daily cases from June 20th to 26th. Officials say this was 53% higher from the week before. Some 591 patients are in severe to critical condition. The health department also reports 51 deaths from that period. The hospital bed utilization rate was at 18.1%, while the ICU utilization rate was at 14.9%.
San Juan City's mayor says the COVID situation there is under control despite a note rise in infections. Mayor Francis Zamora says the city so far has 37 active COVID cases. All cases are mild or asymptomatic and no one has been hospitalized. That's why he believes an escalation of the COVID alert level is not in order.
I would rather stay at level one at this point. It's not the time to panic. Yes, the numbers are increasing, but let us not panic because we have our vaccination. We simply have to continue following all health and safety protocols. Right now, the ICU utilization and hospital utilization are very low. We have enough quarantine facilities, and I believe each and every LGU has learned the experience from the past 2.5 years. This is not new to us. We have battled this in the past 2.5 years, and I'm sure each and every LGU is ready just in case there will be a surge.
The Philippines postpones the rollout of COVID-19 booster shots for non-immunocompromised minors aged 12 to 17. It was supposed to have started over the weekend, but health department or health officials say a recommendation from an independent advisory body prevented them from doing so. The Health Technology Assessment Council had said non-immunocompromised minors can only get boosted once an area reaches 40 to 70% booster coverage for all priority groups and the adult population. An advisor of President Duterte opposes this recommendation.
Yung age stack, sana they become more reasonable. Kasi itong mga 12 to 17 na kabataan natin, na may pasok ka na sa face-to-face this August, bumayag na sila sa pagbigay ng mga bakuna dito na first booster lang naman to. At ang bagal ang galaw ng age stack. Let's move faster.
There are many lessons that...
Meanwhile, a former health secretary also wants the country to step up its booster drive.
I think that we should widen the eligibility of those who can receive booster shots at this point. I can see that there are millions of vaccines that are supposed to be expiring soon. I don't know why we should not be using these vaccines to protect our people.
The Philippines gets a fresh supply of COVID-19 vaccines from the United States. The U.S. donated nearly 300,000 Pfizer-BioNTech doses, allotted for those aged 12 years old and above. They arrived Monday night and will be the last batch of COVID jabs the country will receive under President Rodrigo Duterte. But Heather Variava, the charge d'affaires ad interim at the U.S. Embassy, says there will still be more to come in the future. The U.S. has so far donated a total of more than 35 million vaccine shots to the Philippines through the COVAX facility.
But the United States continues to be very proud and pleased to partner with the Philippines to fight the pandemic together. We look forward to continuing that work with the incoming Marcos administration because COVID is still with us and we still need to fight.
And again, we would like to thank the American people for this donation. And this only represents that the U.S. and other allies will always continue to help us. Now, this will be our last donation to be received during the Duterte administration, and it only shows the support of the U.S. and other allies to the next government.
Overall, the Philippines has received around 245 million COVID-19 vaccines. Based on the National Task Force on COVID-19's latest tally, the Philippines still has about 91 million doses in storage that are ready to be administered. More than 70 million Filipinos have already been fully immunized, but only 14.8 million have received booster shots.